When I came here and we started seeing the tremendous amount of traumatic injuries, extremity injuries that UC Davis sees, we started to think about how can we make things better for these patients.
There are two major problems with patients who have lost their limb. One of them is pain, and the second is the ability to use their prostheses after surgery. Our goal here at UC Davis is to come together as a multidisciplinary team to improve the intuitiveness of the prosthesis so that the prosthesis learns about the patient and adapts itself to the patient.
Close. There we go. And then as soon as you relax,
there we go.
Okay.
The first prosthetic that I received was a manually operated hook, just like you would think that a pirate would wear, but it was operated by cables. And now that I've got this new device, the myoelectric, which works off of impulses, learning and teaching myself to use the proper muscle groups to make it work.
Currently available myoelectric devices use the signals that a patient can generate through muscle activity, through their residual limbs, and read these signals and translate these signals, much like Morse code, into hand motions.
With this hand in particular, we have the psionic hand with the COAP system. The COAP system is pretty much what gives the hand that pattern recognition technology. So when the patient thinks about doing a pinch, we can program the hand itself to do a pinch motion. I love working with patients who don't mind breaking something or experimenting and trying stuff because I know that they're using it, which is what I want to do in the very end, is make sure that I give them something that they'll use.
We have been trained to save limbs, not lose them. And so it is very important personally and professionally for me to be able to restore function to the patient.
We are giving them a piece of their body that they likely lost in an accident or a trauma or someone who might be born without a limb. And so we're giving them that ability to function again.